You are
morning, y'all. Good morning. Good morning. Let's go. Come on in. Let's go. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Welcome to the Everyday Until 8 a.m. Experience. Let's go. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Come on in. Come on, good morning. Good morning, everybody. If you see somebody on the wall that you know, tell them good morning. Let's do that this morning. Let's go. Good morning. Good morning, all over the country, all over the world. Good morning. No matter where you're watching from, no matter where you're calling in from, we're glad to have you here at the Everyday Until 8 a.m. Experience. This is your dynamic devotion and prayer that we provide for you every morning. Thank you so much for joining. Do me a favor, like, comment, share, and tag. Let's make this morning a special morning. Glory to God. Let me let this minister to you. Let's go. If you have a prayer request, please place it on the wall or put it in the comment section, and someone will pray for your prayer right there on the wall. Good morning. Good morning. If you believe your prayer request is private in nature, please make sure you fill out the form and or send an email to admin@amazingchurch.com, and someone will get right back to you. Good morning. Let's go. Let's go.
I want you to raise up these words. Come on and take your seat. Come on and take God. Our burdens and yours. With you, we can be rich. Won't you stand up? Won't you stand up? Come on and take your seat.
Good morning, good morning, everybody. Good morning. Come on. There go Eham. There he is, y'all. Memphis, Tennessee is on the wall. Let's go. Did I see what I think I saw? Come on. Good morning, Pastor Dad. Well, good morning. Come on. Good morning. Good morning, y'all. There she go. There go my mama, y'all. Somebody say hello to my mama. Good morning, Miss Frida. Good morning. I love you, girl. Let's go. I really believe this morning is really gonna bless you this morning, y'all. It's gonna bless you this morning. Let me tell you something. If you know somebody that you can text, you can call, you can send it over to, do it for them now. Let them know that you're sending it to them. When you're done, if the Lord does the same for us, come on, y'all. Miss Missy, if the Lord does the same for us, I'm praying that what he's going to do for your hearts this morning, what he's gonna do, listen, what he's gonna do. Talk, what he's gonna do. What he's gonna do. Listen, Alicia, what he's gonna do. Kennedy, good morning, baby girl. What he's gonna do. Woo! You gotta be in the prophetic right now, y'all. You're a believer, I promise you. If you ever despise prophecy, don't do it right now. Don't do it now. God is speaking.
The Bible demonstrates this in Joshua chapter 6. That there was a kingdom.
All right, all right. Let's go, let's go. Let's go. Come on. Come on. They go Grand Prairie right there, y'all. They go Grand Prairie. Yeah, yeah. Melissa, Texas. I see y'all IG. Come on, that go Decatur, Alabama.
Somebody
Come on, come on. Woo! Yeah. Come on. Yeah. I am telling you, I am so proud of you. I'm so confident in what God is doing, what God is saying. Pastor Ilya, my wife, was up this morning listening to prophets. And the place where we are, the place that we're in, we've got to stay in it. We got to stay in it. Come on. This morning. This morning, your inspiration. Every morning, we're going to give you inspiration. Every morning, we're going to give you motivation. Come on. Every morning, you will have an app. You will get an application, whether it's myself or one of the pastors on the team, or one of the leaders, or even one of the ambassadors, if you are connected to our site, which is going to come up. The ambassadors, give it up for them. Let's send hearts and thumbs up for the ambassadors. They will also be able to lean in and release words, because I'm telling you, God is working this. David, are you with me? God is working this. And so stay connected here. Do this. Make sure that you're getting others connected to this and involved, because God is working through a method that I have not seen before. It's not new. I'm seeing it here in scripture. You'll see it today, but it is new. You cannot shrink back from feeling out of place. You cannot, Kelvin, you cannot shrink back from feeling like you're different than everybody else. That is not an indication of exclusion. That's an indication of uniqueness, yes, but also that God is getting ready to release and utilize gifting tools, thought process, mindsets. Pastor, what are you saying? Derek Golden, what are you saying? Pastor D, what you saying? And some Pastor Dad, what are you saying? This is what I'm saying. I'm going to show you. Let's do that. Let me show you. Come on. Let's do this. Let me let y'all give God praise. Come on. Give him worship. Come on. Let's just worship a bit this morning. I want to get your spirits ready. There's a different thing flowing. It's a necessary need for us to be able to be spiritually in tune in our spirit man and spirit woman in order to receive the seed, the word of God that he is delivering. Come on, y'all. Ms. Irma, you understand how that works. It's not one of those, hey, okay, let's do it. This is not that. This is, let me get my spirit prepared to receive what God is saying, because there's so much being said that's not God that's getting traction. There's so much that's being said that's not God that's getting traction. And so now, because what was once, scripture says it, what was once a lie has become the truth, and what was the truth has become, get this, not a lie, but the truth has become bitter in the ear of those who are hearing, even in the ear of the believer. And so I know that I'm prophesying before I get to this, but I'm saying to you now that you've got to make sure that your spirit is prepared to receive what God is saying, that your heart is in tune, that you're connected to what God is saying, that you're in the gates. Get in the gates, all right? So we enter in with Thanksgiving, the digital Thanksgiving, the digital and physical at the same time. It's hearts and thumbs going up. But also today, this morning, before I give you your inspiration, your application, and your motivation, I want you to begin to worship him. Just worship God. Come on, worship him. Come on, worship him. You can put comments in and worship you. Worship. Worship is a response to a loving, benevolent King. Worship is a response. Worship is a moment. Worship is where he has you in your moment, in your heart, your appreciation for him. Come on, let's bless him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is not something normally that I do, but I'm telling you this word, I want this to get in your spirit. Hallelujah. 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 Listen, if you have not been watching, I know some of you are at different churches, but I'm going to ask you to go to Amazing Church. Go to our YouTube page, and I need you to watch the series, The Gates Are Open. All right, watch the entire series, and you may have to watch it several times. It's through preaching, but the word is the word, the prophetic word of the Lord is there. If you have not been here since October the 22nd, you might need to go back to our and pull up these Everyday Untils and listen to it. The Lord is saying that I'm going to crown the year with my kindness, which means that the year must have not been kind. All right, but he's going to crown it. And then he says that his paths are going to drip with abundance, which is an indication that we have to be in the will of the Lord. We have to be in the ways of God, and we have to be in his ways, because that's where his abundance will be flowing. We want to be in the flow of where God is. That's right. Come on, y'all. The gates are open. The gates are open. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on. Bless his name. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you this morning. We love you. We love you. We love you. We love you. We honor you this morning. Glorify yourself. Be magnified. Come on, I'm going to give you time. Tell somebody. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is settled here by William Murphy, parts 1 and 2. Hallelujah. Bless his name. Come on. Glorify him. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Come on, God. Come on. Come on. God says, I've never been absent. I never failed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So now you got your spirits together. I understand some of you are driving. Some of you are walking. Some of you are moving at the same time. I get that. But I want you to make sure that your ear and your spirit and your attention is here this morning. I'm taking a passage, your inspiration this morning. Come on, let's bless him. It's coming out of Acts, the 18th chapter. Acts, the 18th chapter. Come on. The 18th chapter and verses 9 and 10. Now, Pastor Tanya, I know I'm messing this thing up, but I can't do just one this morning, all right? Let's go. I'm doing 9 and 10. Acts, the 18th chapter. Listen, who teaches out of Acts 18? 9 and 10. Let's get it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, God bless you. Father, we thank you this morning for all that you will say and all that you will do. We give you honor this morning. We enter into your courts of thanksgiving. We enter in with praise. We adore you for being the great God. You are the one who we love and adore. We're thankful, God, that you have called us and that you've drawn us to you. You could have left us out where we were, but God, you brought us into you. And so, God, we thank you. We give you glory for it. We honor you. We lift your name high. We thank you, Lord God, that the word that you're about to give us on this morning, God, all of us, God, inclusive, that you will pour out your spirit, that you will speak to us in such a manner, God, that it's unmistakable, that we know it's you, that you give us strength and you give us the fortitude, God, to stand in the midst, that our faith is strong, God, in the name of the Lord Jesus, that we shall respond, God, and do as you've instructed. We love you. We love you. Your scripture this morning, inspiration. Acts the 18th chapter, verses 9 and 10. Acts the 18th chapter, verse 9 and 10. Hallelujah this morning. I was looking for something. This song was in my spirit last night before I even went to bed. And if some of y'all went to bed late, I undid. But this is in my spirit. We're picking up in a passage of scripture. Now, I normally don't give this whole part, but I want you to get it. We're picking up where Paul was teaching and testifying or preaching to the Jews in and near the synagogue. And he had just came from Athens and getting into the region here of Corinth, this area, this region, Galatia, Ephesus, Philippi, Corinth. He's in the region, y'all. He's entering into where it would be the greatest part of his ministry, and he's being resisted so much so that it begins to frustrate him. And Paul has this picture in his mind that he's the only one that has this word, this gospel. He's the one that God has chosen. He knows it. He knows about being the one. However, in his presentation, he's having a difficult time with the Jews. And when he's looking at this and dealing with this, he's determined that, man, listen, that's it. He's getting ready to roll out, and God's not letting him leave. In fact, the scripture says this. It says, when you look at chapter 18 and verse number 9 and 10, after that, Paul now, here is the word from scripture says, now the Lord spoke to Paul in the night by a vision. Do not be afraid, but speak. And do not keep silent, for I am with you, and no one will attack you to hurt you, for I have many people in this city. Now, when I read this, y'all, it jumped out at me like, whoa. Well, God, the Lord Jesus is speaking to Paul here, and somebody else is watching what Paul is going through. Therefore, Paul, because it says he appeared to him by night in a vision, which is saying this vision is that, remember, that gaze. So Paul is actually speaking what the Lord is saying to him. And somebody, Acts, we believe, quite possibly is written by John. It's in different parts. And so somebody's watching and somebody's hearing. That's saying to you, somebody's watching and somebody's hearing what you're saying regarding the Lord. What you're saying, the Lord is saying. Somebody give God praise for that, because for some, that's an indictment. And for others, that is chastisement. And then for others, that is that for you, that's something to celebrate. We've got to, I want to teach this to you this morning. We've got to watch what we're saying God is saying. We've got to watch what we're saying that God is saying. When you're saying that the Lord told me and God said this, you better watch it right now, because you're going to need to know what God is saying, because somebody else is watching and you don't want to be responsible for causing someone to slip and fall, but you want to be the one responsible to cause someone else to have the strength and believe that God is still God and still speaking regardless of what the outcome is, regardless of which side you chose. We on the Lord's side. Hey! He says, now the Lord spoke to Paul in the night by a vision. The Lord opened his eyes so that he could see, and he spoke what he saw. It says, do not be afraid. That passage right there, that little piece right there, do not be afraid. Don't fear. Get out of fear. Fear is going to give permission for the enemy to attack. Permission opens the door. Remember, fear is a spirit. For God has not given us the spirit of fear. Fear is a spirit. This fear, this is not talking about this healthy adoration for your parent, for God the Father. This is talking about do not be afraid, because Paul was just persecuted and people spoke against him. They cursed him, everything while he was preaching. These are Jews that he's trying to save. He's trying to get them saved. He's trying to bring them to the way. And they're like, no, get away from us. We don't need your God. We got the only God. In fact, the word of God says that if anybody comes telling you that there is another God performing miracles, signs, and wonders, stone them, kill them. And that's what you're trying to tell us about this Jesus that we just got rid of? Y'all, you better hear it. You better hear it. And he said, now I know I was on the other side, and the Lord is the one that transformed me, that got me on this side. Anybody know that you used to serve the enemy and now God got you on this side, that you don't have time to go back, and you've got to be able to handle the persecution of them that won't let you go? Hey! Many times people are not hating on you, they're just hating to see you go. Come on, yeah. Many times people are not hating on you when you get delivered. They just hate to see you go. So you're not going to do this with us no more? Oh, you think you somebody? Yeah, I do. I'm delivered. Don't give up your deliverance for attention. Don't give up your deliverance for acceptance. Don't give up your deliverance so that someone else can be happy. Don't give up your deliverance for likes and comments and shares. Stick with it. Stick with it. Ah! Are y'all hearing me this morning? He says, do not be afraid, but speak. Here it is. The Lord is telling him. He says, don't be afraid. You got to be afraid, but don't be. Don't be afraid. Speak. Say it. Proclaim. Proclaim the goodness of God. Proclaim what you know of God. Proclaim it. Don't be silent. This is not the time to be silent. He says, but speak. And do not keep silent. That's what he said to him. He says, for I am with you. I'm 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 with you. I need to give you this understanding. I need y'all to get this. I'm with you. No matter what you're facing, he's saying, I'm with you. That means this. Your confidence has got to be your faith. Your faith has to be in the Lord. He says, I'm with you. I'm with you. I'm with you. Somebody say it. Say, he's with me. Come on, say, he's with me. Uh-huh. Yeah, you spend way too much time in fear not realizing that he's with you. He's with you. You're giving fear credit. And you're asking the Lord to stand aside so fear can rule. Fear has become an idol for some of you. You live by it. You make decisions by it. You spend by it. Come on. He says, I'm with you. He said, I know what you went through, but I'm with you. And says, and no one who? No one will attack you to hurt you. No one will attack you to hurt you. Why? Because I'm with you. That's what we want to say, right? But this is amazing. This is what it said to me. Take a look at this. Catherine Keys, take a look at this. This is what it says. Tanya Collette, look at this. He says, and no one will attack you to hurt you. For I have many people in this city. Come on. He says, I got many people in the city. God is strategic. He's got Paul in a place where Paul feels persecuted, Marcia. And here's what God says. Because you obeyed me and because you are where I told you to be, don't be afraid. Go ahead and speak. I got people around. They're going to protect. You don't even see them. You don't even see who I have to support you. You don't see who I have to help you. You don't see who I have to protect you. You don't even have to fight. I got people. Somebody say, I got people. You got to be able to let the devil know, hey, be careful with me. I got people. God's got people around. God, when you're in the place where God tells you to be. Now, this is a spiritual, this is what's going on with Paul, but let's take the principle and apply it to our lives, Acts 10. He's saying, get this, he's saying that when you're where I tell you to be, when you're doing what I'm telling you to do, you won't have to shrink back in what I told you to say, because you know that I'm with you, giving you your strength. And you know I got people protecting you. I got somebody around you. I got provision already set up for you. I got you. Go ahead and proclaim what I told you. Go ahead and say what I said. Listen, don't worry that nobody else is saying what I told you to say. You say what I told you to say because I'm with you. Come on. Don't get up in a frenzy, Paul. Don't you panic. Don't you run away. Slow down. Settle down. Tell him, settle down. Settle down. I got you. I got you. I'm with you. And I got people. If you get afraid, I got people. If you get nervous, I got people. If you start, if you think you want to run, if they cussing you out, if they pushing you back, am I getting too hyped this morning? Woo! I got people is what he said. So. What's my motivation? Here's your motivation. Your motivation is the Lord speaks to Paul, opens his eyes in a vision, and tells him to be at peace. Don't worry about the persecution. I'm not leaving your side. So go on and keep preaching. I won't leave you. And then the Lord says, and if I have to, I'll raise up your help. I'm going to read it to you again. Come on. The Lord speaks to Paul, opens his eyes in a vision and tells him to be at peace. Don't worry about the persecution. I'm not leaving your side. So go on and keep preaching. I won't leave you. And if I have to, I'll raise up your help. That's what he said. Somebody, I didn't even wait for y'all to say ready, did it? Well, listen, I might not even wait for y'all to say today, but I think you need to be ready. Whatever job you're going to, Know that God has got you. Whatever situation you're facing, God has got you. Whatever you felt like giving up on, whatever you felt like throwing in the towel on, whatever you felt like persecution was pushing you out, go on and say what he said. Come on. That's right. Somebody said it. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. We got to keep going. We can't quit here. We got to keep going. It's not over. Listen, regardless of what the outcome is of the election, that's got nothing to do with what you're supposed to be doing for the kingdom of God. The kingdom ain't quit. The kingdom ain't changed leadership between last night and today. He won't be impeached. He won't be. Listen, God don't have to worry about getting reelected. God ain't got any competition. There's nobody that's going to run against him. So today, come on, Danetta. Who told you, Danetta? You ready? Y'all got ready? You ready today? You ready today? You ready today? Here it is. Here it is today. Today? Settle down. God's got people you don't see on the job. That's your application. That's your app today. Your act today is this. Settle down. Settle down. Settle down. Settle down. Settle down. God's got people you don't see on the job. That's your inspiration. Acts 18 chapter verses 9 and 10. That's your motivation and that's your act. Settle down today. Come on. Hey, hey, hey. Settle down. Settle. Calm down. Chill. Keep going. Don't stop for this. Keep going. If you stop for this, you can get caught up in a place where God doesn't have people set up for you. Keep going. Do what God told you to do. Settle down. God got people on the job that you don't see. God got people. God got people. Hey, if the Father's got people, that means that you got people. Come on, you got people. You can say it. Come on, Kimball, say it. Say it. Say, I got people. Be careful fooling with me. I got people. Be careful putting your mouth on me. I got people. Be careful trying to plan my demise. I got people. Be careful gathering people to your ideology about me. Your thoughts and opinions don't change God's decision about who I am. He decided who I was before I came into the earth. Come on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on. Let's bless him. Let's bless him. Let's bless him. Father, we love you this morning. Come on back. Come on back. Come on back. Come on back. Yeah, yeah. Father, we love you. Father, we bless you. We need you. We thank you. We adore you. We magnify you. You're the wonderful Father. You're the wonderful Savior. You're the magnificent one. God, we love you this morning. We need you this morning. Thank you, Lord God, when our emotions would get high and rise up. We thank you, Lord God, that you're settling our spirit and settling our hearts, God. We thank you, Lord God, that you're magnified. We give you glory. We glorify your name. We lift you high this morning. Oh, God, we bless you. You are our Father who art in heaven. Holy is your name. Let your kingdom come. Let your will be done here on earth, in us as it is in heaven, God. Let this mind that's within us be the same mind that was in Christ Jesus. Let us have our faith fixed. Let us have our faith fixed on you, God. We declare that our future is brighter than our past. We declare that the latter things, Father God, the latter things in our lives will be greater than the former things. We thank you that you're pouring out your spirit upon all flesh, God, all flesh, your sons and your daughters, Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord God, that we don't have any reason to be afraid, but we shall speak and speak what we believe, God. We thank you that we speak to those things that be not as though they were. We thank you. We speak to the mountain and the mountain must be removed. We thank you. We speak and whatever we bind on earth is bound in heaven. We thank you that we speak, God, and we see the things that we've been praying for, whatsoever things that we desire when we pray. Lord, our prayers, Father God, our prayers are filled with our faith, and our faith is stuck on you, Lord. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we receive that your promises, all the promises are yes and amen for those of us that are in Christ Jesus. And we thank you, Lord God, that we have the things that we have petitioned you, because you hear us, God. You will answer us, God. Your desire is to see us walk in what you have already prophesied for our life. For Your word says, God, that you have a plan for us. And so, God, since you have a plan for us, we will not let those that are in the earth, we will not let the enemy and demon forces distract us and discourage us from the plan that you have, God. If you've got a plan, we bind the attack of the enemy that would try to get us, God, to get in our own emotions and get discouraged about what you already got planned for us. God, let your plan work in our life. Let your plan come forth in our life. Let what you want to have happen, God. We're going to settle in, God. Yes, Lord. We're going to settle in with what you intend. We're going to settle in with what your plan is. We're going to settle in because your word says, God, before we ever entered into the earth, you called us and you ordained us and you sent us to the nations, God. It didn't mean that they were going to receive us with gladness, but God, with boldness, we declare. With boldness, we speak. With boldness, God, we declare that you and your kingdom come and your will be done right here, God, in the name of the Lord Jesus. You are the good shepherd. You lead and guide us by still waters. Father, we bless you this morning. Come on. We bless you. We love you this morning. We need you this morning. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We've almost threw in the towel. We almost quit, God. We almost decided that it wasn't worth it anymore. Father, things didn't turn out all the time the way that we expected. And God, that discouragement and that disappointment had us change our mind in some areas and then lock into some things that we should have let go at the moment of the discouragement. I prophesy you that you have held on to the moment that you were disappointed and you're still living there. And God is trying to work some things in your life. You've got to let go of what hurt you so bad that you changed how you were going to think about all things. God says that I didn't give you that. Remove the filter of fear and pain and walk in the promise of what the Lord has declared for your life. In the name of Jesus, we got to receive that God did not lose an election, that God did not be defeated by the enemy, that God is not overwhelmed by corona, that God is still God. He was God then, and he will be God soon after, and that means that he's God right now. I'm telling you, you've got to open up your heart. You've got to open up your mouth. You've got to open up your mind, and you've got to proclaim that this... Woo! The Spirit of the Lord is upon me to set the captive free. I declare you free now, Father. We receive your word that you spoke to Paul. Since you're no respecter of persons, I love that. We thank you, Lord God, that we don't have to be afraid, but we shall speak. And no one will come to us to attack us because you are with us and you have many people that surround us. God, we thank you. We're going to settle down. We're going to settle down because you got people working on our behalf. Come on, somebody give him praise for it. Come on, give him glory for it. Give him glory for it. Come on, give him glory for it. Give him glory for it. Give him praise for it. Come on, hallelujah. 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 God, I thank you that I ain't what I've been through. I thank you that I ain't what I experienced. I thank you that I ain't what I experimented with. I thank you, Lord God, that I'm not what I was exposed to. Come on, y'all hear that? I thank you, Lord God, that I'm not the pain that I endured. I'm not the pain that I inflicted. I'm not the guilt. I'm not the guilty. No, God, you set me free. Thank you for paying for my sins, Jesus. I ask that you forgive me for all of them. Your word says, God, that you would do so. So we thank you, Lord God, for forgiving us of our sins. And God, we forgive others of their sins against us. We release them, God, so that we can be released into what you have promised for us. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you for forgiving us, God. We ask that you now today, God, that you would slow the number of cases, God, that you would stop it, that you would end it, that corona would be completely gone, eradicated, and eliminated. Father, we thank you now in Jesus' mighty name for those of us that have endured that, whether you have contracted, whether you have relations with that have contracted, whether you've had loved ones lost or those connected to you. God, settle our spirit. Close the door on the attack of the enemy and the access of the enemy. We shut the door now. We shut the door now. We shut the voices now. We love you, Lord. We bless you. We magnify you. We glorify you. You're worthy to be praised. Father, we thank you. Go to hospitals, go to nursing homes, go to homes, God, go to places. May your spirit go, God. And we declare that the death angel, the spirit of death, that if it's not the appointed time that's written in the books, that you must pass over, and that those that are on the deathbeds will rise up now in the name of the Lord Jesus. And God, we pray a special prayer today for all of the citizens of the United States, all of its states, all of its provinces, that God, that as a result of this that we see here in our country, that there is a complete split, a divide. And we know, God, that a divided house will not stand. We ask that you would send your Holy Spirit to be the mender, the healer of our land, the healer of our hearts. That God, as a result of this, that we will find some kind of way, that you will radically transform the hearts of the political spectrum and, God, the reporting in news, media, and outlets. They're all doing the same thing. They're promoting their side. We ask, God, that you put them in position, all of us, to remove our biases so that we can love like you love, that you loved us in spite of, and God, that we will be able to do the same. Strengthen us. We have humbled ourselves. We have turned from our wicked ways. We have repented, God. And we ask, God, that you would move on our behalf. We love you. We love you. Yeah, 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 yeah. Rise up, Father. Yes, God. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, bless him. Come on, bless him. Bless him. Whose report will you believe? I will believe the report of the Lord. Whose side will you be on? I will be on the Lord's side. Hallelujah. 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 Come on. Hallelujah. Whoa. Now the Lord spoke to Paul in the night by a vision. Do not be afraid, but speak. And do not keep silent, for I am with you, and no one will attack you to hurt you. For I have many people in this city. The Lord got people working on your behalf that you don't even know are working on your behalf. God bless you. Listen, this has been your EDU 8 a.m. experience. Thank y'all for joining me this morning. We'll meet you back here tomorrow morning at 8 a.m. Central Standard Time. This has been your Dynamic Devotion and Prayer, and I am Derek Golden, and I love being with you each morning. Y'all be blessed. Do me a favor. Get somebody on with you tomorrow, all right? Y'all have a great day. Call us. Thank y'all so much. Love y'all. Have a great day. IG, hey, we had a few pauses, but thank God that you stuck it out. I love y'all. Love you too, Jeremy. Y'all be blessed. Have a great day. Facebook, YouTube, y'all got the word. Y'all got the word. Here's the rest of it. The Lord is affirming what he's saying through his prophets. And it won't be just one group and it's hidden in a church or it's hidden in a group of people. This word is going to be heard by all, but not received by all. And so the word of the Lord in this hour is that the Lord God is going to crown the year. He's going to crown the year. We've got to fight all the way through to January 22nd. Stay in his ways and speak. He's got people. He's got people. All right. Miss Elaine. Miss Elaine. God bless you. Love y'all. See y'all back here tomorrow morning, 8 a.m. Central Standard Time. Be blessed.